Well, a very good afternoon to you and welcome to Allianz Park for this, our second under 15 NatWest Schools Cup Vase semi-final. It's Bishop's Vesey's Grammar School against Sir Thomas Rich's School, and we are live from Allianz Park. We've just seen Dr. Challoner's Grammar School overcome Bridgewater High School, and they of course will be taking on the winner of this match. Ended up a fairly one-sided encounter in the end, but a very good afternoon to those of you who are joining us for this game. My name's Nick Heath, and alongside me is Natasha Hunt, Rugby World Cup winner in the France Women's Rugby World Cup in 2014, and bidding to become an Olympian as now part of the England Women's Sevens programme as well. Great to have you alongside me, Natasha. How are you doing? Looking forward to another semi-final?
Yeah, really looking forward to watching this one and seeing who comes out on top. Some great rugby shown earlier by the Chandler boys and also the Bridgewater boys, so we'll see what happens in this game.
Yes, indeed. Well, it was a battle of north and south previously with Lancashire against Buckinghamshire between Bridgewater and Dr. Challoner's Grammar School. We now have Bishop's Vesey's from Sutton Coldfield and Sir Thomas Rich's, well, they're from Gloucester. So not so much difference in terms of the geographical stretch between the two sides. But we're really looking forward to this one. It's a pretty heavyweight tie for a Vase semi-final. Both in previous years could have made big dents in the main competition. Bishop's Vesey's been in fine form this year, losing just four times. One of them, of course, was that cup tie that knocked them into the Vase. There have been big wins over established rugby schools such as Adams Grammar and a particularly strong effort over Solihull. Let's have a look at the journey from Bishop's Vesey's up to this point so far. So Bishop's Vesey's then coming through. There's that big result against Adams Grammar. And the quarter-final win over Newhall School. Big wins over the likes of Arden Academy. Then the away win at Princethorpe College. Narrower affair at Stratford against King Edward VI School. And then another close one in round seven for Bishop's Vesey's. But victory's all that matters. And after that 1915 win in the quarterfinal, they find themselves here at Allianz Park. It's Thomas Riches. Well, they're chasing a return to Twickenham, having been there in 2012 for the under 15 Vase final. They lost that day 17-5 to Dauncey, so they'll be desperate to go one better this year. And this is their journey. A couple of games in the cup, losing out to Cheltenham Bournside School. And a couple of tight games then. Churchdown School, fairly comprehensive win, 48 points to nil. 23-10 over Woodlands Academy Coventry, 24-7 against Trent College. And then dispatching of Chislehurst and Sidcup Grammar School, 19 points to 13. Their record's not been quite as good as their opponents, though. They've lost 12, won 11 and drawn 1 this season. But as you can see, their Vase run has been solid, and they will fancy carrying that form through this semi-final, hoping to emulate that 2012 side and reach Twickenham again. So Thomas Riches just going through a few last-minute preparations out on the turf here at Allianz Park. If you've been enjoying our coverage from the first match and are sticking with us, well, it's great to maintain your company. You can keep in touch with us using the hashtag NatWestSchoolsCup. Of course, if you're looking at the hashtag at the moment, well, you will see pictures from the victorious Dr. Challoner's boys. Many congratulations to them. Now it's the turn of Bishop's Vesey's and Sir Thomas Riches. Let's just have a look then at the teams who will be taking the field from the run out in around about 8 minutes' time. Making up the forwards, Siaka Sofal, Hawkins, Pryor in the second row, Aidan Towson, Ethan Stanley, and in the back row, skipper Louis Hanlon is the open side with Robert Honeyhurst and the number eight, James Bishop. Black and Bell make up the halfbacks. Two wingers, Oliver Webb and Hiwakalis, and Harrison Casey and Brogan Ling in the centres. Christian White will be sweeping things up from fullback, and they are coached by Mr. Whiting. A chance to look at the St. Thomas Riches lineup. There we are, Floyd and Wilkinson and Emerson make up the front row. Mars Wilson and William Sanderson in the engine room. Number six, Oliver Edgington, he's the vice-captain. He's scored six tries so far in the campaign. So has Joe Hocking. And then Liam Richards at number eight. And the halfbacks, Oliver Gordon and Daniel Walker, they've actually got equal tallies in terms of kicking so far in the competition. At number 12, Matthew Lampitt at the inside centre. Well, he scored a try in every one of the knockout stages, so can he continue that record? Outside him, Ben Gleeson is the skipper, with Seth Price on the right wing, Andrew Hunter at fullback, and their coach, Rhys Morgan-Davies. Just have a look at the replacements as well. More of an even spread on the bench to what we saw in the last semi-final. And if you're watching this hoping to cheer on your son, your grandson, your nephew, your cousin, well, whatever it is, great to have your company, and we certainly look forward to what should be a gripping second semi-final. Might be worth mentioning that it'll be a completely unbiased commentary, of course. I did have a family representative in the last match, but I hope it didn't shine through, Natasha. Was it too obvious?
It wasn't too obvious. I think you dragged me along with it. We were just supporting great rugby, Nick.
Of course we were. Rugby is the winner. Just a chance to check in with what the coaches have been saying ahead of the game. In terms of Mr. Whiting from Bishop's Vases, it's an honour and privilege to play at Allianz Park. The team have worked very hard throughout the season to get into the semi. By doing so, they've made school history. They've not progressed this far in any national competition. It's provided some fantastic opportunity to play the great game of rugby against some outstanding opponents. It's a very noble little bit of patter from Mr. Whiting about their opportunity here at Allianz Park. In terms of Sir Thomas Riches, well, a few of the players are associated with the Gloucester Rugby Academy. That, of course, is their local patch down there. Coach Rhys Morgan-Evans has coached at the school for the past eight seasons. Pays tribute to some of the coaches lower down the school that gets in the standard of players at this level. Then go on to play under 16s and in the first 15. As far as their under-15s have been this season, they've had a rollercoaster season after a promising start. Sir Thomas Riches' injuries took their toll and they suffered a few heavy defeats. But those have galvanised the squad. They train four or five times a week, working on different aspects of the game. Plenty of decent attendance from them. They've got senior players in the likes of skipper Ben Gleeson, who drive them on to improve. I want to thank everybody for all of the support that they've received, as I'm sure do all of the schools who are representing themselves this afternoon at Allianz Park. So we're building up to kick off then. The announcer at the stadium just going through the teams for the fans and family who are supporting either side. That's what they're playing for. And that West Schools Cup, under 15 VARs. We know they're taking on Dr. Challoners High School. I wonder how many of the Challoners supporters have decided to stay on and have a little look at what their opponents might look like in a couple of weeks' time. The final, of course, the 16th of March at Twickenham. Will be a tremendous day out. I was fortunate enough to go to Twickenham in 1996, I think it was, to support the under-15s from my school. RGS High Wycombe were there, and they were successful on that day.
Throwback Sunday.
Yes, absolutely. Throwback Sunday indeed. I think I had curtains and an undercut at the time.
Classic.
The less talked about that, the better. We're live from Allianz Park. It's the Under 15 NatWest Schools Cup Vase second semi-final. It's Bishop's Vesey's Grammar School against St Thomas Rich's School. We'd love to hear from you. Hashtag NatWest Schools Cup. Got a shout out to Thomas Rich's from Rob Christie. Good to have you watching, Rob. Whether you're watching on englandrugby.com or via some of the school's websites, Twitter, wherever you are across the world, give us a message. We'd love to hear from you. Let us know where you're watching. Have we got anyone watching from foreign climes? We'd love to know where you're watching from. I made a similar shout out when we were covering the England under-20s during the Six Nations a short while ago. And we had people watching from Belize and Honduras, all sorts of wonderful places. Very exciting. So wherever you're watching, do let us know. Whether it's from up in the Midlands or down in the West Country, supporting either of these sides. Well, Natasha, what are you looking forward to from this semi-final? What are you hoping we can expect?
Just looking forward to seeing what these two teams put together. I'm Gloucester born and bred, so I know that it's a massive part of the culture around there. So see what Sir Thomas Rich's does will be brilliant. But equally, I used to teach up in King Edward School in Birmingham, and we used to come across Bishop Vesey's quite a bit. So to see how far they've come, and obviously first time in a national semi-final, which is pretty amazing for them. So yeah, really looking forward to seeing what rugby is on show.
Those are the thoughts of Natasha Hunt, Rugby World Cup winner, and working with the England Sevens towards that Rio Olympic dream. But a dream's being realised for many of these players now, running out at a stadium such as Allianz Park. They're bidding for a chance to play at the home of England rugby at Twickenham. The two sides in the stripes, St Thomas Rich's Bishop of Vesey's, my apologies, in the black. It's a cold day in North London, but the fans will be keeping themselves warm as they cheer on each of these two sides. It's a big moment for these boys, and look how much it means to them. It's great to see, isn't it? We're ready to go. A couple of banners in the stands on the far side. Alexis Leonard is our referee.
Toddy, you good? Mike?
Ready to get underway.
Good, Ben.
And it's going to be Daniel Black to get us started for Bishop Vesey's. His forwards support him with the big run-up. Smart attempt to take off the ball from Lewis Hawkins. It's come back on the Thomas Rich's side. Taken at the back. Christian White.
Blue advantage, scrum! Advantage over!
Thomas Rich's, and this is an absolutely searing run. Eventually brought
15,
down by
move.
James Bishop, but Riches with a really
black.
Early opportunity here.
8, Black, move!
Trying to get it down the back line and create some more space under the posts.
Move, Fonte!
Stitch tackling from Vesey's. They've got width if they can get it out there. The pass was low.
Hands off, Black!
Had to dip low to take it. Here's a penalty to
Thomas Rich's.
Early danger signs.
King, he's called King.
Yeah, Hollinghurst is unlucky there. He just goes past the ball and you're not allowed to go past to come back onto it. Good decision by the referee.
Well, they're going for the tap and go penalty. Initially set it up, and then the try is scored. Inside 90 seconds, the game has its opening score. So Thomas Rich is getting on the board at early doors. It's the hooker, Cameron Wilkinson, who gets over.
Just inside the line.
Yeah, it's a great setup play here. They're taking it in, they all know that the maul's coming, and then rather than shifting it to the back, it's just a simple transfer, slides out, and then great leg drive from the hooker to go over. He's obviously had new boots bought for the occasion. Let's see if he can nudge this one over.
Absolutely, look at those shining away. No problem at all. Well, we saw Dr. Challoners get on the scoreboard fairly early in that game, and they went on to triumph fairly comfortably in the end.
Just wait, nine. Yeah. Just let him get set stationary, and then you can go.
Bishop Beasy is delighted to have got this far in the competition. Will this be as far as they go?
When
what will their response be to that score?
Four, move, yellow!
It's away from Black. Oh, nice little step inside. Vesey's passed to Bell. Bell again, just hesitated, then threaded the little ball through. That's cute.
Nice,
it might have just got touched out from Thomas Riches, did it?
That's yours.
Thomas Richards, defensive line. Of course, no jump.
Keep that gap wide, please, yellow.
No lifting in the line out at this level, at under 15s. Does make the line out a little bit more of a lottery. And as such, it was Sir Thomas Richards' line, but they've lost it. Big carry. Solid carry.
Push, yellow, yellow, push, first guard.
Safeful. And another, but the ball's been
yellow
dislodged.
Yellow line, scrum, hands off, five.
Hocking's going to have to try and tidy that one up.
Advantage over!
From Walker. Oh my goodness, that oval ball, it bounced once, thought it was going out, and it bounced back in field. Support line gets back just in time. Thomas Riches make the tackle. Force the turnover as well. Really strong work. They got themselves in a decent position. And Christian White got himself isolated.
Yeah, it's great body position from Liam Richards there in the breakdown.
Your nice side and low. Line, please, Black.
Knows when the attack is coming from Bishop Beasley's and manages to steady himself just to be able to soak up that challenge.
Yellow advantage, scrum, hands off, Black!
Around the fringes.
No advantage coming from the knock-on off the line out. Scrum, yellow ball.
No advantage. Shout-outs coming through social media. Watching that, whistles come from Rome, Italy. Come on, VZs. Monty Williamson, lovely to have your company, Monty. Good luck, Tommy's. Message from
Crouch!
Vicky Rantala. Good luck to Bishop Vesey from Walsall RFC.
Set!
Come on, you bandits. Scrum is effective for Sir Thomas Riches. Trying to get through.
You're off your feet. Didn't try and pick it up, Black. You just put your hands on it.
Vesey's to try and get over that ball, but
hands off, Black!
Feet. Referee called it clearly. Oh, now then. That was a very cute piece of skill, and it looks like it might be a try in at the corner. My goodness me, what was that all about? Luke Pardo gets the score, but let's have another look at that. Natasha, have you seen anything like that at this level?
I'm not sure he meant it to go that far, to be honest, initially watching it. He kind of flicks it out the back and then it's an absolute wonderful.
We know he's going to be watching this back later going, I meant every bit of that. How dare they suggest it was chance?
You would always claim it. You would always claim it. Brilliant.
Gents, did they throw the ball away?
That in just a moment. My goodness. Pardo in with the score.
It's a great flat pass.
Oh, Walker.
Absolutely sensational. Out the back, flicks it up over the second row, so that's some height to get up over there. And then well caught, well read by the winger. Yep. Pardo in the corner.
Gents, the only thing so far is just at the breakdown, both sides want to jackal. I'm just questioning whether or not they're actually trying to pick it up or win the penalty by just putting their hands on it. Your opinions?
Asking whether the teams are trying to pick the ball up or whether they're just trying to put their hands over the ball to win the penalty. Obviously a penalty is more advantageous.
So I'll get him in a minute.
Interesting that he's asking that question, and great bit of refereeing if that is his thought process.
Well, absolutely.
Time
he's
you run, Black.
His
time
to keep
you
an
run.
Eye on that, whether they've got any views.
Thank you.
Restart from Vesey's.
Black advantage, scrum.
Taken in, there is an advantage to Vesey's though. Will Sanderson.
Not forward.
Scrum. One on.
Skipper, when you're trying to jackal for the ball, your team are going beyond the ball and bringing their hands back on it. I need to be on the ball straight away and picking it up straight away, otherwise I can't reward you. Okay?
There we go.
There's your mark.
Just listening to the rest of a moment
Ali.
Ago.
Ali.
And then we hear it give the message very clearly.
OGD.
Crouch! Bind!
Harry Hanlon told how his players need to perform in that breakdown area.
Stay nine.
Balls in from Daniel Black. Looks to try and get away himself, Black. He's got swallowed up with a tackle. Can
tackle!
Back on
the late yellow! It
is there for Vesey's. Scrum half is at the bottom. Needs help from his back
colleague.
Got it,
scrum.
Bishop, but the ball was lost in the pass.
Stay.
Sir Thomas Richards.
Advantage over.
Kicked the ball away. They had the advantage, but now it's going to be a chance for
not held.
Christian White to run it back. Black again.
Tackle only, Tony. Tackle only.
As well they might to try and find some more room down this left-hand touchline.
Move tackler.
Oliver Webb on that occasion.
Just an extra yard for me.
Yes.
Knock on off Black.
Yes. Nice,
scrum.
Confuses.
Yellow ball.
Smart.
Cheers, Sally.
Never.
Say?
Just coughing up possession.
What's wrong? Okay. 12, 13. I just need an extra yard on the back foot, please. Thank you.
Good work.
Plenty of communication coming from the
Jets, just form up, his boot will be on by the time you get ready.
Send them back, boys.
It's tricky at this sort of under 15, under 18 level in terms of the officiating. There's still
we'll wait,
a small element of reminding players of the rules and
crouch!
The rules of the game and almost semi-coaching at moments. Obviously, not with any influence on the results.
Set!
Just making sure the players understand fully what's required of them.
Yeah, and it's really important at this age group because a lot of the time penalties can be not made because the referee's talking them through what they need them to do. So it's brilliant refereeing so far.
Game flow, absolutely.
Yeah, broken. Move one! Ball's available.
It's in there now for Black and he gets it away. We've got an opportunity to try and open up here a little bit. Vesey's loose on the floor. Thomas Richardson there. Joe Hockett once more proving to be getting into the thick of it. Loose.
Play the ball.
White.
It's off a boat. It's off a boat.
There's a flooding numbers into the breakdown to get turnovers as soon as the pressure's on Vesey's. It's costing the side in black. Here comes Thomas Richards again.
Mark!
Walker stepping inside that time. It's away from Gordon. Have they got numbers if they could find it out to the left side? I think they had the overlap.
Hands off! No, you didn't try and pick it up.
Hold it, Brogan. Hold it, Brogan.
Drive coming on from Sir Thomas Richards.
Ball's on the floor. Player ball. Leave it black.
Where is the ball? Referee said it's available. Gordon.
Ball's done.
Ball's available. No, black. Blacks, no. Release, yellow.
Over the top. Who's going to pick and go on that occasion? The try scored by Joe Hocking. He adds to the total he's got so far.
You haven't got the message
it's
about the jackal.
Yeah.
I've got
season.
To see elbow movement. Hands on the
That's
ball is not enough. I've got to see it being picked up.
Using the pick and go around the fringes and patiently get the score.
Yeah, really good patience shown there by Sir Thomas Richards. They're just holding onto the board, sucking in the Bishop Vesey defence, and then they just run out of numbers. Really simple score in the end, just picks and dives over.
Well, three tries to the good inside the opening 15 minutes of the match.
Yep.
Here you see, despite the best efforts of all of that counter-rucking, great carry, sucks in four defenders, and then they just run out of numbers on the other side. Body height's too high, and they're just diving over, nice and low. Brilliant finish.
Daniel Walker. Conversion effort. Got a better lift on it, but the direction wasn't quite there. So he's still one from three now. But Bishop Vesey's nil.
Kicker. The last
Thomas
one was perfect.
Richards,
the one before
17.
Your six was slightly on the line. Yeah, just get it timed perfectly for me.
Bishop Vesey's need to get themselves onto the scoreboard. Need to compete for this restart.
Thank you, kicker.
Changing off the left foot. And a penalty goes to Vesey's.
Exactly as I said, skipper.
Score of the first try of the match.
Yep.
Hanlon told again then under the post that he needs to see elbow movement, he needs to see that ball being lifted to give the penalty. First opportunity, Hanlon's picked that ball, elbows are moving, and penalty goes to Vesey's. Good captaincy.
He's looked to try and go for every inch.
Yellow hold, mate!
It's not come out for him.
Thank you!
It's over the head of Black. White picks up. Got to try and get away from the first tackle. First tackle is brilliant.
13.
Skipper Ben Gleeson. Trying to help the situation. Vesey's give away the penalty.
Skipper.
Great work from the skipper. Thomas Richards. Skipper.
Skipper.
Well, we can look again. Christian White.
Great tackle, isolated tackler, gets out, and then the 13's just comes straight in from the side. He's got to get back behind the ball and come through the gate.
Broken link, desperately trying to help his fullback, Christian White.
Textbook tackle from Gleeson.
Yes, absolutely. So, this is straight down the park. One from three so far, Walker. How can he fare at walloping it straight ahead? got the legs. And it's over. Great effort from the fly half. And it takes Thomas Riches up to the 20-point mark. Bishop Vesey's nil. So Thomas Riches 20.
Not bad for a 45 metre effort, is it?
No, absolutely.
Very great kick.
Very impressive. Bishop Vesey's, they can do with some possession in the St Thomas Riches half, and that was dangerous.
Six, just a timing issue.
Who was jumping for the ball.
OK, four.
Yeah. Was right on the
just get your timing right, please, okay, six.
Timing has to be right there. Almost a little bit winded, perhaps. He's OK, physio's just on to give him the once-over.
Yeah, on me.
Penalty kick down the field. Hasn't found touch, if that's what he was aiming for. Black. This is perhaps with a little bit of room here. They take the outside line. Running into the space, Harrison Casey.
First knock on off black, ball's second off forward. Yellow. Scrum. Yellow ball.
I don't think the Bishop Vesey's trying to do positively. They're just undoing themselves with the errors.
Over here.
Yeah, too many errors coming in from Vesey's at the minute.
I need you to stay down. I'm seeing you coming up round the side. I need a longer bind from you, though, OK?
They're just compounding it because the simple knock-ons that they're giving back to Bishop Vesey's, and they're maintaining their possession really well.
Bind! Set! Stay down, loose head.
Just up the halfway line.
Up you get!
Thomas Riches go again. Picking round the corner. Slight to suggest moving forward there, but Thomas Riches still have it. Gordon with the little chip over, thinks he might have spotted some room in at the corner, but Vesey's were looking to defend.
Knock forward off yellow 10.
Thomas Riches endeavour to come forward and try and claim that chip through. They've just knocked it on.
Come on, lads! Step it up now!
Thought it was really a kick aimed at the corner, that little chip over, but
gents,
it ended up sitting up on the...
Make sure you're binding on the shirt, not the arm.
Perhaps the firmer rubber crump surface that you have here at Allianz Park.
Nines. I've got both of you. Put yourself square to the scrum. I don't want any off centre. Yes, put yourself square before you put a ball in.
Far be it for me to take anything away from a scrum half.
Yeah, it's clearly a tactic they've worked on. Gordon's put three or four box kicks in now, and each one of them has a really good chase. So whether the kick's good or not, then the chase, it will always make it better.
They look to go down the short side. Belted down the right touchline.
Okay.
Daniel Black, certainly one of the brighter players for Bishop Vesey's, but perhaps at times he's trying to do too much himself. I've seen him run away from support.
Keep the gap, Black. Black, keep the gap.
He needs to keep his teammates around him. Line out is loose. Bishop Vesey's. Try and tidy it up. It goes backwards again.
Now forward off yellow in the tackle. Scrum.
By the striped shirt.
Black ball.
So Thomas Riches.
Come on, Tommy! Another big try.
Yeah, it was a great decision to kick. They're in their own half. They've not had a lot of ball. Good decision to pin so Tom Riches back down, but just the execution on the kick is just off the outside of his boot.
Nine. How are we coming, gents? Sorry, it's just the nine disappeared. I had to call him back. You've got to stay here in competition. Yeah, so.
Just be lively, yeah?
Go on, Joe, all day. He's in your pocket, mate. Let's go, boys.
Crouch!
Come on! No chat from the nine, then. In your pocket,
set.
Boys, come on.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nothing riles props more.
Nine, stay nine.
It's away from Daniel
Black. Tammy, back!
kick is, well, a little bit aimless, I would suggest. To give it to Thomas Riches, the chance to run it back, although entirely directly from Seth Price. Eventually makes 5, 6, 7 metres.
Rock!
Taken by Gordon again. Looks for his hooker, Wilkinson.
Push.
Then a pick and go down that short side.
Move four black!
Gordon, oh, little option of the dummy.
Push, push.
Looking to go down that short side again.
Backwards!
Has the ball stayed in field? It has.
Push, push.
Thomas Riches really looking for try number four on this one. Feezy's defence holds up a little better. That ball goes backwards, but it was well snaffled up by Sir Thomas Riches.
13 hands off Black! He's through the middle, he's legal.
Referee told him hands off, and in my view, he was in a perfectly legal position to compete.
Police tackle of Black!
Hey, Rockland!
Sir Thomas Riches holding on to possession well. Trying to punish, loose ball, seized upon by Bishop Beezy's
as it was
knocked forward
scrum
in the tackle.
Black ball.
Yeah, good defence from Beezy's there. They just held their line really well and kept coming forward, so put them under a little bit of pressure. Disappointed to see them kick the last ball. They had Sir Thomas Riches had three defenders up and 13 were giving them a real corner. They had three in the backfield, so the kick's never really on. They need to run it until that winger comes up so that they then have an option and they have more of the field to kick to. Be interesting to see where they go on this one.
They could do with Natasha Hunt giving that advice down at half time, couldn't they? Great insight from a World Cup winning scrum half.
It's that, yeah, rather than that.
Easier said than done, though.
Agree?
Well, exactly.
Have a look.
Oh, that camera shot, all I can see is the word donuts there. Getting a bit peckish in the commentary box. Also see, actually, as a witness at the end of the game, the parents, of course, could go and get their photos of the day. Photographers working the event. We'll be sending their pictures back to that booth so that they can take away the mementos of
teams
playing here at Allianz Park. Great for the family photo albums. If such a thing exists in this world.
It's a fantastic occasion. Under 15 level, playing at Allianz Park, win or lose, it's just brilliant.
Remember the message I gave you?
The opportunity that these guys have.
Yeah.
Yes,
okay.
Indeed.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's why Ben put me in. Yeah.
Even better if they play at Twickenham, though, here.
Well, quite. That's the target on the horizon for both of these sides. And also Thomas Riches, certainly with a keener eye on that at the moment, leading as they are by 20 points to nil.
Okay. Time on.
He gets time.
Black ball.
Started.
My last one's on.
Crouch.
Trinidad ball.
Bind. Set.
Balls in for Black. Oh, the ball was charged down on the attempted
22
clearance box kick. This is repeated again because it just means it's a 22 dropout. We've gone into touch.
Come on, Ali, hurry up, mate!
Yeah, great work from Eddington on that far side. Really good recognition and great timing to get off, lose his bind and then charge the kick down.
Black then with a 22 dropout. Free kick. Not to get too much depth.
Rock! Hands off Black!
Riches. It inevitably puts Vesey's under pressure defensively. Gordon pulls two of his forwards back and says, you'll pick and go from
Rock!
Here.
Rock!
Well, that's a curious call for me.
Time off.
Yeah. Skipper. The player in the right position with his hands on the ball.
Skipper.
The referee told him to take his hands off.
He's unfortunate there. The referee's deemed that the ruck has formed.
You need to speak to your team about the jackal. I'm calling ruck. They're not listening. They're keeping their hands on it and they're denying quick ball. Speak to them, because I might have to escalate it.
So really, okay, really tricky one there, because he's deemed that the ruck's formed, so two players are over the ball initially, whereas I think that he's the first person on the ball before that second challenge comes in. So there you see, he's on the ball, challenge comes in, and he stays strong over that ball, so he's really unlucky there.
Well, he said he's denying the opportunity for the attacking team to get quick ball. That's the role of a back rower.
He's done it.
To do.
Yeah, he's done it extremely well there as well, Bishop. Unlucky.
From Ethan Stanley.
Black advantage, scrum.
It's been knocked off.
Yeah, lads, nice.
They'll forward off yellow first, then off black, scrum in 15.
Yeah, Vesey's just need to settle now. They haven't had a lot of possession, and when they have, they've coughed up easy ball. They just need to get their hands on the ball, maintain it, play through the phases, and really challenge Leicester Sir Thomas Rich's defence.
Yeah. Yeah. Crouch!
Sit!
Bind.
Let's move this
from
bind.
Set.
From black. It's not coming back immediately, but now the scrum half can get it away. And it comes down the Vesey's three-quarter line.
Hands off, yellow!
Fly half bell.
Ball's available.
On the jump down!
There for black once more.
Release yellow!
Which is off quite narrow. If Vesey's could get ball and get wider, they might cause a problem or two. It's a really solid carry.
Ball's there.
Shaka effective when he's had the opportunity to
get
the ball up and get yards. He did so again there. Now another penalty goes to Vesey's. Can Bell get them another decent position down the touchline to build a further attack?
Great carry there by Playful, but you need quick ball off that. When you've got momentum like that, you need to absolutely smash that ruck, and now you need to get hands on the ball. Black just needs to move it as quick as he can.
Here's your mark.
Vesey's line out is one at the front by Sir Thomas Riches. His bobbling ball though.
Black advantage, scrum!
And out.
Black advantage!
Vesey's had the advantage. It's as if they'd have won the line out themselves anyway. Trying to get the drive on.
No advantage off the knock on from yellow.
He says they'll reset it from the scrum.
Black ball.
This is as far into Sir Thomas Riches' territory as Vesey's have been all match so far. Such has been
get the
dominance of the team from Gloucester.
Come on, boys. Thought they were unlucky at the line out. It looked to me as though Sir Thomas Rich's boys were closing the gap there.
I'll come.
They've got to stay straight. They're not allowed to jump across. It seemed as though they were, as soon as that ball's released.
Thank you.
It doesn't matter if it's uncomfortable, because
less than two.
Crouch! Keep him out, Marsh, Tommy. And it's ended up with Vesey's ball.
Crouch!
Full three
Bind.
Just out of your picture.
Set.
Stacked on the left side, which given it's a central scrum. Well, it's an interesting choice.
No flank to back.
He's shaping to possibly go blindside with the number eight, which is what he does. Going to need the Vesey support to stay with them. And the ball pops out for the scrum half. Safeful. Another one of the big carries from him. Gets the offload away. Went to ground, but it was picked up by Lewis Hawkins.
Put him down carefully.
Stanley driven back. Good defence. Black had to snap that one off the floor before it was taken into Sir Thomas Rich's clutches.
Push, push! Use it!
He just needs someone to play scrum half.
Rock, hands off, yellow!
Penalty Vesey's.
Rock was formed instantly. Ruck was formed instantly, then he used his hands.
Referee saying hands in the ruck. Sort of a dubious call on that at the other end of the field a few minutes ago.
Scrum. Scrum called.
Vesey's have opted for the scrum. Well, certainly a three-pointer when you're trailing by 20 points. It's not going to get you terribly far into closing the deficit. If they could turn this into a try, well, it's certainly...
Gents, hold the five till the ball's picked up, please. Yep.
That's clever, Kuri.
Yeah, it's a good decision there from the captain. It's an easy shot at goal, but like you say, they need
Crouch.
That seven-pointer, really.
Bind! Set!
Straight out then, Tommies!
Never went into the scrum.
You can't drop to your knee to then hook it. Keep your feet under you, OK? It's dangerous. OK. Straight out the tunnel, gents. Scrum. Black ball.
Last roll of the dice in this first half from Bishop.
Thank you.
Trailing by 20 points.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Ready! Went in for Black and wasn't really hooked again.
Straight out the tunnel, gents, again.
What are you saying, sir?
Shooting back out.
Come on, see work here.
I'm enjoying Oliver Gordon's work right now. True, playing to the whistle.
Every time it comes out, he's keen to just grab it and head off upfield, isn't he?
Get yourself square, nine.
He knows exactly what he's
Crouch.
Doing as well.
Plenty of chat.
Bind! Set!
That time it is.
Hold it, yellow!
Picked up initially by eight and handed on to James Bishop to carry out.
Push, 10.
Now Black to Alistair Bell. Looking to try and create the men on the far side. They go round the outside. Did they need that extra play through the middle? They get over. And Harrison Casey gets over the inside centre. They were almost overcomplicating a very simple 3-on-2, Natasha.
Oh, really well. I think it was even a 4-on-2. Initially, I thought, why are they not just going hands, run straight and pass? It's the basics done well. You see, she get over the try line so many times, but luckily, Casey's gone on the loop and then he's seen the defence again of overchase and he's just managed to step back in off his right.
Made the best of what was, an overcomplicated set move when it was all there for the taking.
Because all you see here is all Casey needs to do is run straight.
Yeah.
The 13's the last man and then they've got two outside him. But luckily he's got the nous about him to step back in and find his way to the try line.
So Alistair Bell. Oh, sorry, it's not Bell. And laying them out to try and add the extras for Vesey's. Absolute silence at Allianz Park. Shanks the effort a little bit. But Vesey's are onto the scoreboard and it has a slightly better look to it now than it did a couple of moments ago. Half time here at Allianz Park. Second semi-final of the under-15s NatWest Schools Cup Vase competition. It's Bishop Vesey's 5, Sir Thomas Rich's school 20. Three tries scored by Sir Thomas Rich's, the first one inside 90 seconds. And Harrison Casey getting the last try of the half to bring Vesey's back into it. So we've got an opportunity now just to have a look back at the tries from that first half. And this was the first one. Penalty a few metres out, backing themselves to tap and go their way to the line. And as the defence was splintered, Cameron Wilkinson, the hooker.
Yeah, what's great about this is the patience on it and then the momentum shift from Vesey's. Brilliant leg drive in the great body position to go through. Sorry, Sir Thomas Riches.
And then try number two. The ridiculous brilliance from Walker, has to be said. Putting in Pardo to score the try.
Yeah, I think anyone, any level would be pleased to get that assist, wouldn't they?
It's absolutely fantastic. It's the sort of thing that if you saw in an international game, kids would be running outside into the garden and trying themselves. He'll never live that down.
Here we see just really good patience from Riches, really good carries, low body positions that close to the line, and then the Vesey's defence just too high, initially missed the tackle, missed the man, he just rides it and then jumps over in the corner.
Yes, hocking the number seven, getting try number seven of his campaign. He's been a prominent figure for Sir Thomas Riches in that first half. Working hard around the fringes defensively, but also carrying well.
And then the last try of the half, brilliant pass from the nine, good pass from the 10, and we just feel like they overcomplicated it slightly, but great recognition not to throw the dummy and then step back off the right and find the try line.
Yeah, they made it all okay in the end there, Harrison Casey.
Yeah, he'd have had a lot of explaining to do if he didn't finish that one, wouldn't he, after that?
Yes, absolutely. So that's how things are poised then, 15 points between the two sides. Second 30 minutes to follow. Do keep in touch with us on the hashtag NatWest Schools Cup. Let us know where you're watching. Getting news that the teams are arriving for the Cup semi-finals that are taking place later on. 3 o'clock kickoff will be the next game after this, the Cup semi-final between Millfield and Sedbergh. What an enthralling encounter we're expecting between those two sides. Big rugby schools with great pedigree in this competition. But we should be in for a thrilling Vase final as well at Twickenham. And that one comes around. We've got Dr. Challoner's Grammar School in that final. Sir Thomas Riches looking like the favourites to be joining them. There is Joe Hocking. Mentioned him at the break. Away from Gordon. Trying to get it through the hands quickly. Pass from Lampett, just didn't quite get there on the last occasion. Tackles are being made by Vesey's, but still there for Gordon. He's the diminutive scrum half, but you can tell out there he's calling the shots. Gordon digs. Big solid carry into contact from Miles Wilson. Now they go short side, but it's just been knocked forward. Vesey's will have the scrum.
Yeah, over eagerness to work around the corner from Thomas Riches. That was a great spot by Oliver Gordon. It really was on down that blind side. Vesey's has worked around the corner as well. Just needed a few people to stay and run straight.
Yes, perhaps a little wider as well. They were almost all on top of each other down that short side. If anybody is passing the area of North London Allianz Park, do bring an electric blanket for our commentary position. It's a cold one in North London today. Set! Come on, Cam! Might have to might have to pop out and have a little run around to keep the legs warm. Well, now then, scrum half under all sorts of pressure there from Sir Thomas Richards, and Daniel Black couldn't do anything to stop himself being bundled into touch there.
Yeah, as a scrum half, it's your worst nightmare to have a back row like that on top of you as soon as you touch the ball at the base. It's a difficult thing to deal with anyway, but when you've got an alert back row like that, it's really quite challenging.
Line out from Sir Thomas Richards is well taken. Trying to get through William Sanderson. Oh, but it's popped out for Vesey's. A gift for Robin Mays Pryor. Black just knocks on at the base, or rather knocks it back. Referee happy that it went backwards. Coming from the coaches down below us, look after the ball is the call. Certainly been a looser game than the first semi-final that we were watching earlier. Not quite as much flow to it. It's there for Black. Short pass and the carry. Hawkins. Black goes digging once more. He's the next man to carry it forward for him. Solid play from Vesey's. Coming. Bouldering out of their 22, and now they get away again. And it's the try scorer, Harrison Casey, up to the 10 metre line now. Vesey's with some good go forward. If they could get the next try, they're really going to make this match interesting. Got a fair way to go to get to the line yet, though. Over the gain line once more. That'll do. Alistair Bell gets the ball onto his blindside flanker, James Bishop. Bell again, he's chipped that one. Outside the 22, there's a fair amount of pressure on the man as he kicked it away, and Black will get a chance to gather it. He's all on his own there though, and they'll pop him into touch again. It's an area of the field he keeps spending a little too much time in for his own liking. I think perhaps finding the support on the inside might have been a quicker option for Black there, rather than trying to do it all himself.
I'm not sure he knew he had men on the inside. That communication has to come in from the outside backs there. They were completely on if that ball could have just gone.
Sir Thomas Richards. Don't waste any time with the line out. Comes down. Gordon gets it away. Kickers slightly cross field, but not shallow enough for the Sir Thomas Richards back line to really get onto it. So it's snaffled up well by Christian White from Vesey's. Now Bell. Trying to find some room to set Oliver Webb going. Harrison Casey's starting to have a more of an influence, similar to what we saw at the end of that first half, the inside centre. He's got decent acceleration and good feet as well. Black, Bell, Safel over the 10-metre line. And offloads to Louis Hanlon, the skipper. We saw him on that big busting run to help play get out of the half. Sir Thomas Richards, well, they've wrestled possession back, have they? It's with Gordon. Finds Walker, kick is charged down. Oh, and then it's just knocked on by Vesey's Hiwakalis.
Safel just needs to carry there. There's nothing worse than being offloaded to as a static man. He's dragging in so many defenders. If he can just keep his leg drive going, go forward, and then quick ruck, Vesey's are still on the front foot.
These are views of Rugby World Cup winner Natasha Hunt. My name's Nick Heath. It's great to have your company wherever you're watching this NatWest Schools Cup. It's semi-final stage in the Vase competition currently. We are moving on to the Cup competition semis after this game. 3 o'clock kickoff and 5 o'clock kickoff in both of those games.
Then, boys.
Okay, we're waiting now. We're in the game.
A, B, C, 48 then, boys.
Tommy.
Moment of stoppage in play.
Come on, boys.
I can see late Palmer White being prepared for Vesey's.
Boys, up here, boys, all the way up here. Let's go. Boys, on the mark.
Time on.
Come on, let's go.
Nine.
Boys.
Remember what I said.
Oliver,
no, I've got a
Crouch! Bind! Set!
I think they're going to kick this. You can see by how flat the line is.
One black, hold it!
They've got blindside, perhaps through necessity rather than choice. Little chip downfield from Gordon. Fly half white, deals with it well and then gets the bounce. And then goes into touch. Good little kick back from the fullback.
Thank you.
Andrew Hunter was just trying to get his hands on it, but couldn't.
Four man.
Nothing worse than a bobbling ball. Never know where it's going to bounce. Good nudge from White.
Yes, it was. Can Vesey spoil this line out?
Carried back!
White is under it, needs to communicate with his winger, which he does. Shapes the kick for a moment, then comes forward, gets past two tackles, then Walker put the kick up, brings the man down.
Oh, but it's yellow advantage, scrum!
Richard's side, and they might have room down this
advantage
side
over!
The tacklers. Stepping back in off the left boot is Luke Pardo. Scorer of the second try for Thomas Richards.
Move five black! Five black didn't roll quick enough.
Get out of the way. Saiful has been pinged.
Five black, not rolling.
Oh, sorry, no. In fact, it was Ethan Stanley. Man on the sharp end of the referee's whistle.
Here's your mark.
Yeah, it's unfortunate for Vesey's. Stanley just staying in the contact because Saffield's in a really good body position, straight on the ball. No excuses there for Stanley. He's got to get out.
When the scrums go that way, keep straight for me. Here's your mark, Black. Open it, please, Black. Thank you.
It's in and it's won by Vesey's.
Ripped in the tackle, play on!
Not a rip in the tackle, but I think it was ripped.
Three release
Vesey's
on the floor.
Now then, is there any competition for this? Is this going to come
That's
out?
A mole!
Vesey's have got a bit of go forward, but I don't know that anyone's going to be
still moving.
Stop
okay.
One.
Unsuccessful mole.
Get a ball. Possession.
Sorry, thank you for listening on the floor.
That ball.
Thank you for listening on the floor.
Rolling ball. The team that takes it in has to be able to use it. If it's not getting any momentum, then it will be the turnover.
I'm being told the same thing from behind you that I've spoken to you about already. Yes. Let's take a step to the left, please, Nine. Thank you.
A word with
Crouch!
Scrum.
Bind! Not stable. Let's reset. Just get that inside shoulder out for me a bit. It'll give him somewhere to go and it'll keep you stable. There's your mark. Time off.
No, we just have
yellow three. You're going for a substitution for the moment. I just want to check you out with a bit more time. Okay, it's rolling subs. It's not a problem.
Well, I think actually it's a decision to be able to have a look at James Emerson and whether he's got more of a knock than perhaps they thought he had when he got
hookers,
some attention
hookers.
A few moments ago. So
make sure the Nines don't show the ball, but just keep your feet down until that ball's in, just allow the ball to get in. Don't show it unless you're going to put it
yeah,
in.
Yeah, the introduction of the head injury assessment is so key, especially every single
keep
level.
Keep your feet down until the ball's in.
As a player, you never want to be pulled off the pitch, so the fact that you can get pulled off, have a quick assessment, and then put it back on if you're deemed safe enough to, so it's a great introduction.
Certainly other people
Crouch!
Who have got your best well-being at heart.
Bind! Set!
Gordon.
Hold the drive!
It's got stuck
Black,
up the front row's feet though, as you can see.
I'm stopping that purely for safety. It's gone up on the mark.
Big
it's dangerous.
Whistle for the referee.
No one's at fault. It's just the pressure going up.
He's concerned over the safety of the players. So. Well, that's understandable.
If you don't put it in the middle, he will call it now. Okay? Put it in the middle.
Yeah, Ollie, look, that's the line just.
Gordon is under a lot of scrutiny in this one, isn't he?
A lot of scrutiny, but he hasn't been pinged yet, so he keeps pushing the law.
Crouch!
Fair play.
Bind!
Scrum half union.
Set!
He did just have a cheeky look over his shoulder to make sure the line, see if the linesman was actually looking as well.
Well, on that occasion, again, is hooked by Vesey's. How much influence officials on what Gordon was up to.
It's all right, but it's fine. The ball's available
for Daniel
seven.
Black. Gordon's opposite number. Should the ball have gone wider then? And Vesey's had the opportunity.
It was on his feet.
Well, he opted to step back in there. I think the players on his outside would have been screaming for that and wanting possession. If they weren't screaming, well, perhaps they should have been. It's now a penalty.
10.
This should be well within the range of Daniel Walker.
Sort your timing out on the tackle.
Yeah, he's made some really good ground going up through the middle using those feet of his, Casey has. And I think on that occasion he thought that potentially he could have got through, broken that first line of defence. But it definitely
Gents,
needed
can
to
you
go.
Just watch when Black were in possession from 9 to 10, just the slightly the timing of the tackle on Black 10, please. Timing of the tackle on Black 10.
So Daniel Walker. Attempt to add 3 points. Left-footed, straight through the posts, no problem at all.
Sorry?
First score of the second half goes to Sir Thomas Riches. Walker with the penalty, it's Bishop Vasey's 5. Sir Thomas Riches 23. Started. Oh, big miscommunication, and also the ball not travelling far enough
kick?
At all, really. And that's just
scrum.
An unforced error that brings around more pressure as the team in the lead have just scored the last points will get handed the scrum.
Just bring your head a bit higher for me.
Yeah, we talk about compounding errors. We spoke about it in the previous game. They need to make sure simple things like the kick going 10 and then just put the pressure back onto Sir Thomas Riches, playing there for a little bit. As it is, they've got an attacking scrum on the halfway.
Set!
Out we come.
I need your head above your hips because otherwise you're going to cause yourself an injury. Keep your head above your hips and get your inside shoulder out. Thank you.
Care of these players.
Making sure they all know what they're doing. Huge blindside here for Sir Thomas Riches.
Crouch!
Be surprised if they don't go 8-9-15 around the corner.
Set!
Comes back on the Vesey's side. Black runs away now then. They could have an overlap here if the winger could stay wide enough. Black's trying to do it all himself. Passes back inside to his number 8.
Backwards.
The referee says it went backwards off Sir Thomas Riches' player. So Vesey's could still come. Carrying it well. Casey's in there.
Fine, first man, legal.
But Sir Thomas Riches have.
That's a no!
Executed the turnover brilliantly, but if Vesey's can hold them up, well then they might win possession back.
Taken in by
will.
Black scrum.
Vesey's with the momentum coming forward that time.
Yellow 16.
Yeah, that was that huge blindside I was just talking about, but instead of Thomas Riches using it, then Bishop Vesey's managed to get down there. I think winger initially could have stayed a little bit wider, like you alluded to, and that pass could have gone. It was a simple 2-on-1, but credit to the Riches defence, they came back well, scrambled really well.
Bind!
Yes, there might have been an opportunity for Black to put his winger away, really.
Come on,
straight out the tunnel again.
Oh, a little bit of afters between these two.
And a ball in the back as well.
seconds in.
Hollinghurst made sure that he had the last say in that one.
Crouch! Behind!
Everywhere that Oliver Gordon is.
Set!
What am I walking, son?
Yeah, it's alright.
Set from Black.
Who's coming?
Right to the left hand side through Bell. There's Casey. Good feet. Half gets around the first tackle.
Ball's available!
And they get the ball to the ground. Push. Needed to do that quickly and they managed to.
Move yellow, hands up!
Carry forward from Hawkins. Ball's there again for Black. Stayful.
Police yellow!
He's the first man. They go blindside. Have they got the men there? Step back inside. For a moment, Louis Hanlon was going to be the one to score it. Black. Safe full.
Release!
He's short of the line. Then there's a second movement. I think they think the try's been scored.
Vesey supporters.
But it is a second movement from Seyful. It was possibly the clearest second movement you could ever see.
Yeah, you completely stop. So the referees allow you to keep moving or to reach out if you're still going forward, but he was completely stopped on the ground then and then decided to bounce again. Really obvious and really clear penalty for the referee to give. Unfortunate because it looked for all money that they were going to score that one.
Just under.
Four. They just needed to be recycled and they could have had another go.
Open yellow, open the gap. Yellow. Step. Thank you.
This is where the big man goes down. He's short here, sorry.
Momentum dies and then he just goes again. Too tempting not to put the ball back and recycle.
Off yellow in the line, scrum in 15, black ball.
Have made an error from the line out.
Black three, substitution.
Now changes are going to be made.
Scrum's here, gents.
Leaving the field, replaced by Leighton Palmer-White.
There's your mark.
Come on, Tommy!
Just under 15.
Stay on your mark, stay on your mark.
I think possibly some information I've got on my team sheet.
Crouch!
As Ryan Bassett has come onto the field.
Bind! Set!
Oh, now a break from Vesey's. Straight through the middle. Brogan Ling with the second try for Bishop Vesey's, and he gets in straight under the posts.
It's come from absolutely nowhere. What a brilliant play. So simple. Ten just stands up his man, and then what a great line pick by Rogan Lee, straight through and under the posts to make the conversion easy.
Well, 7 points for Vesey's, and that gets them into double figures. Playing 23, just tightens the scoreboard up a little bit. Vesey's can get the
Come
next
on.
Score. Well, that will certainly make things very interesting indeed.
I think the fact that Casey's carried so much in this game really helped out Ling then. A lot of the Richie's defence were just eyes focused on him, and then Ling takes his opportunity and takes it extremely well.
10 down there when you made that tackle, you're kicking out for the ball on the ground. Please don't, because I don't want to have to penalise you, especially under your posts. Yeah.
Interesting bit of refereeing then. If he's kicking out for ball under the post, surely that's a penalty, whether he wants to penalise him or not. As it is, it doesn't
Backwards!
Matter if they get the try.
Mo! We'll be sensing the chance to be able to come back into this now. There's still.
Taken in by Black,
of the
turn
game,
over.
Just as I say that, it's Thomas Richards with the turnover of possession in a good area of the field.
Yeah, momentum swings are massive in a game like this. Obviously, Bishop Vesey's have got their backs up now. Got their tails up, sorry.
Bind!
If they can get the next score, it's massively game on.
I don't know whether you can see it.
Hold the drive, Black! Balls out!
Allianz Park.
Black advantage, scrum!
Come on. Thomas Richards.
Forward off yellow. Scrum.
Now he's sleet beginning to fall.
You haven't listened. I am going to penalise you.
Above us here. Barnett.
Come on, boys. Gents, you need to listen to me just for the push, all right? It's starting to go close to a metre and a half. Just tune in as you're pushing.
Just simple steps. Simple step out, beating his man in first receiver.
I'll try and shout louder, though.
What I really like about that is the change of pace as he changes his footwork. So he's coming, he's going a little bit slower, steps off his left, and then that real burst of pace. Defender can't stay with him. Oh, my God, that was just slow motion. He's a bit too quick for that to have been slow motion.
Casey again with another scoring run, but ran out of pitch.
Black on the line.
Black
on the line.
To Thomas Rich's players. I think there's a bit of frustration creeping in
Black
there.
Black on the line.
That they're letting Vesey's back into this game more than they would have liked to. Let's not forget they were 20 points to nil up.
12-23. Use it. Eight, stop. Thank you.
Chasing back. Oh dear, now then a loss of footwork. Suddenly White's got the
ability
to jump on that. Iwakalis just lost his footing as he tried to get down on that, but enough time to create the platform for Daniel Black to be able to make that clearance. But
Mark Black.
Thomas Rich is still with a good area of the field if they can get the set piece right. It's an area that Beezy's have spoiled.
Stay Black!
To his hooker.
Yeah,
the left wing is Pardo.
Ball's available.
Black will turn over ball for Vesey's. KC. Referees adjusted.
Forward.
Just gone forward there.
Hey, Tony. Pass was forward. Scrum.
In the assistant with the call yellow on ball. The far side. So, Vesey's looking to make the most of that counter attack ball from inside their own 22.
Yeah, they'll be disappointed with this. They just needed someone to have a bit of an injection of pace.
And stay
go forward,
straight.
Ball in hand, and set a platform for
now
them to play on.
Magic.
Nine. Okay. Crouch.
Set.
Bind. Set. Thank you, nine.
Referee praising Gordon for the straightness of the feed there.
Just spin. Scrum. Thank you. Everyone now. Everyone now.
Come on then, Tommy. Big shot, boys.
I really enjoy this camaraderie between those two.
Bind. Set. Yep.
The referee's making him put it in straight. He's probably never lost so many scrums against the head. So Thomas Rich is now with counter-attack ball, but it's not easy ball. It's not well cleared. Vesey's trying to avoid the whitewash there, but they couldn't as Iwakalis is pushed into touch.
I think he was in touch, in possession of it, yeah? We'll take the line out then.
Yeah, Rich's defence is holding really well. Every time they're going towards the touchline, they seem to be in numbers, just shepherding them in there, using it as an extra defender like you always get taught.
Black 5, black 14, substitution.
Good decision 14, to kick, but unfortunately black. The execution not quite there. And then great teamwork to get this into touch.
There's your mark, thank you, that's the gap.
Here are the changes we've made then.
Push one. Use it!
Thomas Riches. clear that straight down the throat of scrum half Daniel Black. He'll look for the opportunity to counter-attack Brannan. Well, the support line from Harrison Casey, and they've got men outside. Casey, well, he does like to yeah, check back in field, and he loses the ball. Then a slightly curiously chosen kick.
No advantage, the kick's got nowhere, gents. We'll come back for the knock-on.
We saw.
Scrum.
Just to see what
yellow ball.
One of whom they'll be meeting in that final took on March the 16th.
Let's just bring, let's bring the height of the scrum up an inch or so. Okay, on that side for me. Yeah. Keep your head up as well.
Okay. Flat line. Flat.
Crouch.
Hey, Rob, ready.
Bind.
Ready for it.
Set. Black through the mark. Yes, nine if you want. Black.
If we kick, is that our line out?
Yes.
Boys, it's their line out as we kick.
You're outside, it's their line out, yeah.
Thomas Richards just being told what the choices are. Kick downfield, Vesey's with it. Hollinghurst.
No!
Running it back. Oh, that's really good work from him. Tackle was good as well. And stepping back in field, Lewis Brent Iverson.
Move yellow!
Brief little snow flurry gets heavier.
Move yellow!
Black. To his big number eight, James Bishop. And then the break from Black himself. Now then, he's got a last line of defeat to beat. Last line of defence to beat, rather. Got the support line from Hanlon, the skipper. And then Harrison Casey, is he going to get his second try of the game? Casey's in. And things are getting tighter towards the end of this game.
Yeah, it's a great finish by Casey. I don't think he needed to run quite as wide as he did, making the conversion pretty difficult for his centre pairing.
Two and a half.
But a great
two
finish.
And a half.
He really backs himself, this boy.
Yes, he does.
Just heard the referee say as well, 2.5 minutes left to play.
Okay. What's our clock is our best estimation as we go through the game, but there have been a few stoppages in this one. Snow is coming down ever heavier. But the cheers go up as Brogan Ling gets the conversion. And it's now just a four-point game. What a dramatic conclusion we're going to have to this one.
How important was that kick?
Absolutely huge. It means that a try will do it rather than just a try and conversion.
Vesey's ball retention has been better in
behind
the second
the
half.
Ten.
We mentioned it in the first half about the fact they needed to keep hold of the ball. Easy knock-ons they were given away. Let's see if they can do it.
Daniel Black, a little offload. Carried on by Bishop. Black again.
Get it. Round the corner. Move yellow!
Easy's issue has been holding on to ball in the contact situations. They've got to be stronger there, although that's loose from Black. And to Bell. Going backwards in his own 22.
Hands off yellow, rocks formed!
Still time on the clock.
Penalty advantage, Black, high tackle.
Penalty advantage is being played. Daniel Black. Strong half, but at the centre of a lot.
10, keep it low. 10. 45 seconds. You've got time for the line out if you want it.
Referee says there's 45 seconds remaining.
That's a gamble.
Wait. Captain? Scrum called. Black ball.
All you've got, nothing left on this pitch.
Big moments this then.
45.
They've got to be clean from the set piece. They've got a long way to go. 45 seconds remaining. The referee did say to Vesey there would be time enough for the line out, but they opted to go for the scrum regardless.
45 seconds.
Shoulder out, one. Shoulder.
Tommy, give it everything.
Crouch.
Oliver Gould communicating.
Bind.
With his team.
Set.
Come on.
Natasha, is your nod.
Yeah, so difficult game. Not many people have shone too much in this game, but Oliver Gordon has been at the forefront of everything good that's gone through, which is obviously as a nine, you've got hands on the ball a lot, but his communication throughout, not only with the referee, but his team has been outstanding. And for that reason, and the temper that he's played at, he is my man of the match today.
Great reasoning, and certainly can't fault the choice. Length throughout the game. He's got a role to play here as well, as Daniel Black looks to set the platform for his side.
Build
something. They've got a long way to go up the field if they are going to make a telling winning score count.
Yeah, look,
there goes Black.
Black and Casey, well marshalled.
Still in there, 22.
Stolen in the tackle.
It's been stolen.
Release
the tackle
on the floor,
from
Black.
Thomas Riches.
Ball's available. Ball's
just
available.
Just going to play keep ball until the time's up.
Move to Black. Hands off, Black.
Coaches are screaming for the ball to be cleared off
16.
The park. They're just going to carry and look after it now. Big tension on the sidelines. Gordon sticks it into touch. And that is the end of the game. Sir Thomas Riches will be in the final at Twickenham. They join Dr. Challoner's Grammar School. It was a much tighter conclusion to the game than they would have expected, given their 20-point lead just before half-time.
Congratulations. Thank you, Ben. Enjoy it.
Fair play to Bishop Vesey for coming back into it. They gave it everything they've got that second half.
Yeah, they just gave themselves a little too much to do in the end, didn't they? Fantastic fight back from the boys in black.
Thank you, Alex.
But unfortunately, ran out of time.
Three tries in the first half from Sir Thomas Richard, two from Bishop Vesey's in the second, but they've just stopped short. It's a final score of Bishop Vesey's Grammar School 19, Sir Thomas Richard's School 23. That's the sort of competition you like to see in a semi-final. The under 15 Vase final will take place at Twickenham, contested between Dr. Challoner's Grammar School and Sir Thomas Riches' school. So we'll have some post-match reaction for you in just a moment. Natasha Hunt is begun her journey downstairs, but let's just have a quick look at the tries that made that game. Well, this was the first one, scored by the Sir Thomas Riches hooker Cameron Wilkinson, as them all split. He was able to get over for the score. And Gordon then feeding the ball. That was the incredible pass from Walker. And that set Luke Pardo in into the corner. But I think we are now just going to interrupt our replays because we've got the chance to get some post-match reaction pick side with Natasha Hunt.
With the Tommy Riches winning head coach Reese. Reese, give us your initial thoughts on that.
What a game. One absolutely fantastic advert for the game of rugby union. You know, you couldn't fault both sides. Vesey's, we knew that in that last game that they played in the quarters, they came back from 15-0 down. And we were very, very mindful that we weren't gonna fall into the same trap. But you know, they like to give me a heart attack. I haven't got any more hair to lose. But you know, they've enjoyed themselves today, so absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, brilliant. And it was a great result for you guys, obviously, and a fantastic game of rugby. At halftime, what were the messages that you were sending to the boys? Because obviously with that initial lead, was it just a case of hang on? Was that what you were saying to them about them coming back?
To be honest with you, they know so much about the game. They're so comfortable in their execution of what they want to do. I allow them to make those decisions. Sometimes it's a little bit easy for a coach to run on and give advice and what to say. It's those players who are out there who make those decisions, and they're mature enough to do that. And sometimes they just look at me as if to say, just shut up and leave it to us, please.
That's fantastic. How many leaders would you say you have in the team then? Because obviously it's the boys on the pitch that are doing it. You can't say anything when they're actually playing, so that's a great way to go about it. Have you got a lot of leaders throughout the group?
Absolutely, yeah. You know, you're talking 5, 6, 7 players who really, really push the others in training. They're there before me in training. They get the first drill set up. They warm themselves up. They have a say in team selection. I can't ask anything more than, and I said in the programme that regardless of today's result or next week's result, I'm just immensely proud of them, and they're a pleasure to spend time with.
That's brilliant. And looking forward then to Twickenham, obviously an amazing opportunity for the boys to play at the home of rugby and for yourself to coach there. What will you be looking to do within the next couple of weeks? What sort of training will you be doing? What will you be focusing on going into that game?
I'll change absolutely nothing at all. You know, it's the training sessions and the way they're set up has allowed the boys to get where we are. So I'm not a believer in tinkering with things for the sake of it. I did that last time and we lost.
Fair enough. Well, there you have it. Reece, Davis, good luck for the next match. Obviously, enjoy Twickenham and enjoy the occasion. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you. Good luck. Best of luck.
Well, those are the thoughts of the Sir Thomas Richards coach. And our thanks to Natasha Hunt for the post-match reaction. We can just pop back to those replays then of the tries scored. So once again, the scoring was initially opened by Cameron Wilkinson. And then skill from Walker, the little reverse pass out the back, looping over to send Pardo through. And then the third score, and it came from Hocking. Hocking jumping over, certainly in the running to potentially have grabbed him out of the match, not himself. And then Vesey's at the end of that first half, and they got the score from Casey. And that gave us a half-time score of Bishop Vesey's 5, Sir Thomas Rich's 20. And then second half, Brogan Ling scything through on first phase ball. And then Harrison Casey. Well, there was an initial break from Daniel Black. Then it popped up for Casey. And he just got head down to get over the line. It tightened the game up for the last couple of minutes. There was the thought that VZs might mount the attack to get themselves back in front, but they just fell short. They'll be back in the competition next year. Sir Thomas Rich's school have a day at Twickenham to look forward to. They will play Dr. Challoner's Grammar School on March the 16th. Do get your tickets to get along and see that one. We will be moving on in our live coverage this afternoon from Allianz Park to the NatWest Cup. A semi-final between Millfield and Sedbergh will kick off at 3 o'clock. But for now, from all of us, from the second under-15s NatWest Cup Vase semi-final, it's a very good afternoon.